ఆదిభ్యో బ్రహ్మ విద్యా సంప్రదాయ కర్తృభ్యో వంశ ఋషభ్యో మహద్భ్యో నమో గురుభ్యః సర్వోపప్లవరహిత ప్రజ్ఞాన ఘన ప్రత్యగర్థో బ్రహ్మాహమస్మి సోహమస్మి బ్రహ్మాహమస్మి. ఓం ప్రపన్న పారిజాతాయ తోత్ర వేత్రైకపాణయే జ్ఞానముద్రాయ కృష్ణాయ గీతామృతదుహే నమః. ఓం నమో వెంకటేశాయ. మై బెస్ట్ విషెస్ అండ్ పరిపూర్ణ ఆశీర్వాదంస్ టు ఆల్ ద వీవర్స్ ఆఫ్ శ్రీ వెంకటేశ్వర భక్తి ఛానల్. మే ద ఆల్ మైతి శ్రీ లార్డ్ వెంకటేశ్వర బెస్టో ఆల్ కైండ్స్ ఆఫ్ ప్రాస్పరిటీ, హెల్త్, వెల్త్ అండ్ ఎటర్నల్ హ్యాపీనెస్ విత్ పరిపూర్ణ లక్ష్మీ కటాక్షంస్ టు యూ అండ్ ఎంటైర్ యువర్ ఫ్యామిలీ మెంబర్స్. లెట్ అస్ బిగిన్ భగవద్గీత వర్డ్స్ నెంబర్ 30 ఆఫ్ 6th చాప్టర్. శ్రీ భగవాన్ ఉవాచ యో మాం పశ్యతి సర్వత్ర సర్వం చ మయి పశ్యతి తస్యాహం న ప్రణశ్యామి సచమే న ప్రణశ్యతి. భగవాన్ కృష్ణ ఇస్ లెటింగ్ అస్ నో ద కంప్లీట్ బెనిఫిట్ ఆఫ్ ది 6th చాప్టర్. హీ థాట్ బ్రీఫ్లీ ఇన్ జనరల్ వే ఇన్ ద వర్డ్స్ నెంబర్ 27 and 28. In the 29th verse, he started explaining the benefit from the standpoint of traditional aspects. Now, as a traditional way, when you learn the benefit, you will experience more clearly. So, what are the benefit that I could get by studying this 6th chapter? Because the Prathama Shatka is about to complete, he has contented all the chapters in different steps. Now he has completed. Now by completing that, what a person will get, will experience, that's what is thought, which has to be experienced. If he would have followed with proper understanding, with a proper discipline, these are the benefit one should get. First of all, he will get the proper perception towards his own body, mind and sense complex. So for him, now there are two things in his body, mind and sense complex. The first understanding, he could realize there are two things. One is Nityam, one is Anityam. So Nitya part is nothing but the consciousness which is in the form of I. That I is imperishable. The body comes and go. Even the body when is alive, it goes under all kinds of modifications. Shadvikharavath Vedanta clearly says, the asti jayate vardhate viparinavate apakshiyate vinashiyati. It exists in the womb, it's being born and it grows and it gets all kinds of modifications. After 30 years, after 45 years, it slowly starts decaying. Finally, it perishes. That is the all modifications which takes place even in every day in the alive state itself. Therefore, the body undergoes the modifications. I am not. This is the self-clear perception one could have by completing 6th chapter with a proper way. So by this understanding, he gets the clarity and he gets the clear vision to see the world. Now world, how it was introduced to us when we were born, the world was introduced as the father, mother, sibilants, friends, relatives, and the particular language, given identification. You are an Indian, you are an American, you are a London person. So this is the way the world was introduced to us. And we also developed. So the world in the beginning, it seems to be a wonderful color. Because a child, you see, whatever she sees or he sees, they are endowed with curiosity. Mom, what is this? What is that? What everything is? Whatever the object, it amazes. It becomes excited by seeing the world. Slowly, world changes its dimension. I mean the nature. The world turns to be a competition. Now world is, everything is nothing but competition. When you go to study in the school, you have to give the exam. You have to compete with others. You have been taught to maintain your degree, your percentage, and your grade. All this gradation gives so much pressure. Now you become like a pressure cooker. Every student you see, whoever goes to college or schools, they are overloaded from the childhood itself. Even nowadays, from the 2-year-old child is sent to the school with all the burdens. They call it kindergarten. So that education has imparting the competing attitude. Now world seems to be a place where the competition are filled with. So when you grow to be an adult, the world seems to be very lovable. Though the competition is going on under as the pressure, but for you it's a romantic world. After marriage, the world changes. The world changes and gives more pressures, and you could see only responsibilities. All the responsibilities and the world which you have to prove yourself to be that I am. You have to prove to the world, yes, you are the responsible, and the person who is with endowed with a responsibility, taking care of yourself, taking care of your wife, taking care of your family, children. When you see the children, you become very responsible person. Then after 50 years, the world becomes worried. The world, it makes you to understand you are not fit for the world. It's a unique experience. The world continues, but you feel that you are not able to go along with the world. You are backing yourself. Now these are the experience about the world. World, we think, is the place of threatening, giving pressures, lovable, ups and downs. Nowhere it is said as it could get or give complete satisfaction. You were longing for satisfaction, one object to another object. You kept yourself completely busy to achieving something. From the childhood to up to the death, you are endowed with achievements and expecting to achieve something. So you kept yourself with a longing, one object to another, one goal to another. We call it the relay race. Is it the world? The world means it's like a chaos. Everybody is endowed with pressure. They don't know how to deal with themselves. And they think that this is what the life is. But the person who could realize his real nature and who could be at or who could establish at the real nature, for him, world is nothing but bliss. The perception about the world changes. He won't see the world, the place of birth and death, the place for the competition, place for all kinds of sorrow and little bit of happiness. No, for him, the world is nothing but Ishvara. Yo mam pashyati sarvatra. He could see the God. Immediately people can ask, no, these are all, you know, superstitions. No, not, it's not the superstition. So you can see the God. If you are not able to see the God, you are committing mistake like a Hiranyakashipu. This Hiranyakashipu, who was not able to see the God, even he was not able to understand. He was filled with wealth, health, and even he was filled with all kingdoms, happiness. But his own child was against to him. He proclaimed himself, I am the God, Hiranyakashipu Vaya Namaha. He insisted every citizen to chant that mantra, Hiranyakashipave Namaha. But his own son denied, I won't say, Om Namo Narayanaya. Don't chant that idiot's name, I am your God. Chant Hiranyakashipave Namaha, Om Namo Narayanaya. Don't make these idiotic things, I will kill you. Om Namo Narayanaya. Oh my God, somebody can change this child? Om Namo Narayanaya. Show me that Narayana, where he is. He is everywhere. Are you an idiot? He is not anywhere. No, he is everywhere. Everywhere. Can you show him? He is in every atom in the form of consciousness. No, I need him to come in front of. Is he there? Here. He started breaking everything. Then something came out as the Narasimha Murthy. That's what the Ishvara is. Ishvara need not to make the face as a Narasimha. Every object is nothing but the Ishvara. That is the perception. He could see everywhere Ishvara. And also, Sarvam cha mai pashyati. He could see the world in the Ishvara. First, he could see the God in the world. Then he could see the world in God. It's known as Ishvara Darshanam. There is going to be the 11th chapter which will explain a lot. 10th and 11th chapter, it teaches Ishvara Darshanam. Vishwarupa Ishvara Darshanam. The world is nothing but God. The world exists in the God. That is the clear understanding he gets. And not only that, by having this understanding, now the world is place for only bliss, happiness, moksha. He won't get the threatening, or he won't become afraid of the world. For him, world is not the place of fear. It's not the place of competition. World is not the place of competition. We unnecessarily make. I tell you, I request every parents, don't pressurize your kid. And he is born not to give the exams. Exams are there, but we are not giving how to be given. We should not make psychologically pressure. The exam is the normal phenomenon. Ask him to study every day. No, that's what we are doing. That's what we are making him to study. You are making him to study means it is as equal to pressurizing him. Don't pressurize our kids, children. That's not the way we have to approach to the youngsters. They have their own abilities, talents, because they are continuing with their own karma phala. The bodies are changed, the mind is the same as before in the birth. We are, means being the parents, you are only providing physical body, the subtle body and causal body. The mind is not given by you. Only the physical five elemental body which can be nourished by only food is only being given by you. Every parent should realize it. When you understand about yourself, when you could understand about what the world is, you will get clear understanding what to be done hereafter. That's what said in the last verse, Ikshate Yoga Yuktatma. Ikshate means he gets the clear perception about the self. He gets the clear perception about the world. That's what we need, clear perception. The Shastra gives it. These six chapters, though they are not dealing in detail about Ishvara, it will be giving later on. From chapter 7 to 12, Bhagavan Krishna is going to bring in elaborate way. The same content will be dealt in elaborate way, how to understand the world. As we saw, this 18 chapter have been divided into three shatkams. Prathama Shatkam means the first six chapters. They only deal with Tum Padartha Visheshaha. Tum Padartha Visheshaha means as an individual consciousness. It talks about the individual personalities. It gives the complete detail about individual personality. This individual personality, when it is explained, at least a little bit, this collective personality also should be taught. That's what Ishvara. The world is nothing but because of Ishvara. We understand God as the creator first. And also we understand God is nothing but the world. That understanding alone, he has said here, Yaha mam sarvatra pasyati, who can see me everywhere, means God is all pervasive. And not only that, who could see the world in me? Because this is two-cornered statement. This two-classed statement will help you to understand the consciousness which pervades all the universe. This is the proper understanding. If a person gets this understanding, what would be the benefit he would get? He is given in the second line, Tasya aham na pranashyami. For him who sees world is nothing but me, the God says, who is nothing but me, for him I am very much alive. If a person just, you know, invokes a God in a small rock or small stone, I am very much alive there. I'll become alive. Therefore, we have many varieties of puja methods. Even trees are worshipped. If there is a banyan tree with a neem tree, we worship a lot. Every tree belongs to one God. This Bel tree we symbolize as the Ishvara, Lord Shiva alone. Tulsi is Narayana or Lakshmi alone. Because he has said, I am very much alive to him. So when he invokes me, even in a haldi, in a turmeric powder, I am very much alive to him. It's a beautiful method of understanding Ishvara. I exist everywhere. If he sees me, I project myself. I make myself to be alive to those persons. When he looks at this world as nothing but Ishvara, so Ishvara's job is what? To bless. That's what he say, Tasya aham na pranashyami, means I will become very much alive when he believes I have to become alive. I won't perish myself. Means I won't be absent in that place where he believes. I will make myself to be there, to be alive as he wishes. Yo yo yam yam tanum pasyati. So that is said. Whatever the way, whatever the form he wishes, he worships, I become very much alive in that form. And also, Sachame na pranashyati. For me, he won't perish. It means I will bless him. I won't allow him to perish. I will bless him. I will protect him. Whatever that he needs, he wishes, I would give definitely. That's what the second line, it's a great boon. This is the great prayojana benefit by having the clear darshana. Just you do only one thing, you shift your perception. When you shift the perception, your every work become worship. When you see everything is God, so what will you do with the God? Will you do business with the God? You will just have the prayer with the God, that every karma will become prayer with these two understanding. That is the great benefit by this verse. This is said as the prayojana of the sixth chapter alone, because God, he may not or might have not thought that I would extend the chapters. No, now he is giving the solid benefit from the perspective of the world. Two kinds of benefit I've been told. In the next words, he gives one more benefit. Let us read it. Sarva bhota sthitam yo mam bhajatye katvam asthitaha sarvatha vartaman opi sayogi mayi vartate. This shloka, it's a final understanding about yoga or shastra. The complete essence of shastra is given in this one shloka. Because two kinds of perception will be very helpful for this understanding. Because so many religions are there. In our Sanatana Dharma, so many branches are there. So all branches will make them. Branches means I am talking about Shanmathas. We have Ganapatya, Saura, Shaiva, Vaishnava, Shakta, Kaumara. Ganapatya means Lord Ganesha is Upasana Murti. Vaishnava means Lord Vishnu is the Upasana Murti. Shiva, Saiva means Shiva is the Upasana Murti. Sakta means Shakti, female deity is Upasana Murti. Saura means sun is the Upasana Murti. Kaumara means Lord Muruga or Kartikeya is the Upasana Murti. In all these Upasanas, the both perception are kept in the form of puja itself and in the form of understanding itself. When you worship, you have to understand it. When you show one ekamukha deepa, the one-faced light, there is only one light. Then dvimukhi, so two-faced light, trimukhi. So like when you show that, every light, the count of light symbolizes the tattva. So these understandings have been kept as the kriya. Kriya means that we show all the gestures in the form of arati, in the form of mudra. Mudra means, you know, making gestures with the fingers, like these are all mudras. So all these mudras, every activity in this puja is based on this understanding. That the 31st words will understand from the next episode tomorrow. Harihi Om Shri Guru Bhyo Namo Namaha. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnamevavashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi. Harihi Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Harihi Om.